वन यस देयर आर अदर्स हु से आवर लॉर्ड ग्रांट अस द गुड ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड एंड द हियर आफ्टर एंड प्रोटेक्ट अस फ्रॉम द टॉर्मेंट ऑफ द फायर 202 इट इज दे हु विल रिसीव ए हेवनली रिवार्ड फॉर द गुड दे हैव डन surely Allah is swift in reckoning 203 and remember Allah during these appointed days whoever departs swiftly on this second day is not sinful neither are those who stay behind till the third seeking additional reward so long as they are mindful of their Lord and be mindful of Allah and know that to him you will all be gathered 204 there are some hypocrites who impress you with their views regarding worldly affairs and openly call upon Allah to witness what is in their hearts yet they are your worst adversaries 205 and when they leave you they strive throughout the land to spread mischief in it and destroy crops and cattle Allah does not like mischief 206 when it is said to them fear Allah pride carries them off to sin hell will be their proper place what an evil place to rest 207 and there are those who would dedicate their lives to Allah's pleasure and Allah is ever gracious to his servants 208 O believers enter into Islam wholeheartedly and do not follow Satan's footsteps surely he is your sworn enemy 209 if you falter after receiving the clear proofs then know that Allah is needed indeed almighty all wise 210 they are waiting for Allah himself to come to them in the shade of clouds along with the angels if he did then the matter would be settled at once and to Allah all matters will be returned for judgment 211 ask the children of Israel how many clear signs we have given to them and whoever trades Allah's favor after receiving it for disbelief should know that Allah is indeed severe in punishment 212 the life of this world have been made appealing to the disbelievers and they mock the believers those who are mindful of Allah will rank above them on the day of judgment and Allah provides for whoever he wills without limit 213 Humanity had once been one community of believers before they lose faith. Then Allah raised prophets as disbelievers of good news and as warners and revealed to them the scripture in the truth to judge among people regarding disputes. And no one disputed the scriptures except the very people who received them after clear proofs had come to them out of jealousy. Then Allah by His grace has guided the believers to the truth regarding those disputes and Allah guides whoever He wills to the straight path. 214 Do you think you will be admitted to paradise without being tested like those before you? They were afflicted with suffering and adversity and were so violently shaken that even the messenger and the believers with him cried out, "When will Allah's help come?" Indeed, Allah's help is always near. 215. They ask you, "O Prophet, what way they should donate?" Say, whatever donations you give are for parents, relatives, orphans, the poor and the needy travelers. Whatever good you do, we certainly were known to Allah. 216. Fighting has been made obligatory upon you believers. Though you dislike it, perhaps you dislike something which is good for you and like something which is bad for you. Allah knows and you do not know. 217. They ask you, "O Prophet, about fighting in sacred months." Say, fighting during these months is a great sin, but hindering others from the path of Allah, rejecting him and expelling the worshippers from the sacred mosque is greater sin in the sight of Allah. For persecution is far worse than killing, and they will not stop fighting until they turn you away from your faith, if they can. And whoever among you renounces their own faith and dies as disbeliever, their deeds will become very void in this life and in the hereafter. It is they who are residents of fire, they will be there forever. surely, those who have believed, emigrated and struggled in the way of Allah, they can hope for Allah's mercy, and Allah is all forgiving, most merciful. 219. They ask you, "O Prophet, about intoxicants and gambling." Say, there is great evil in both, as well as some benefits for people. But the evil outweighs the benefit. They also ask you, "O Prophet, what they should donate?" Say, whatever you can spare. That is how Allah makes His revelations clear to you, believers. So perhaps you may reflect. 220. Upon this world and the hereafter, and they ask you, "O Prophet, concerning orphans, say, improving their condition is best, and if you partner with them, they have bonded with you in faith, and Allah knows who intends harm and who intends good. Had Allah willed, He could have made it difficult for you. Surely Allah is Almighty, All Wise." 221. They do not marry polytheistic women until they believe. For a believing slave, woman is better than free polytheist. Even though she may look pleasant to you, and do not marry your woman to polytheistic men until they believe. For a believing slave man is better than a free polytheist, even though he may look pleasant to you. They invite you to the fire, while Allah invites you to the paradise and forgiveness by His grace. He makes His revelations clear to the people, so perhaps they will be mindful. 222. They ask you, "O Prophet, about menstruation." Say, be aware of its harm. So keep away and do not have intercourse with your wives during the monthly cycles until they are purified. When they purify themselves, then you may approach them in the manner specified by Allah. Surely Allah loves who always turn to Him in repentance and those who purify themselves. 223. Your wives are like farmland for you, so approach them consensually as you please and send forth something good for yourselves. Be mindful of Allah and know that you will meet Him and give good news to the believers. 224. Do not use Allah's name in your oaths and an excuse for not doing good, not guarding against evil, or not making peace between people. And Allah is all hearing, all knowing. 225. Allah will not hold you accountable for unintentional oaths, but for what you intended in your hearts. And Allah is all forgiving, most forbearing.